Hey, I'm Chris Edwards, and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week, we've got our second installment of our playtester picks. Let's catch up with the rest of the team and see what they've been using out on the court. First up, we've got down the line, Troy Lara. Come on in, Troy, and tell us what you're rocking out there on the court.
So, first item I have up is the ASICS Gel Resolution 7, the Novak edition in the NYC colorway. Just got this in stock and checking it out. I really like how it looks. Super cool look to it. That dark navy color, it's got the Novak logo on the heel. But, I mean, other than the looks, I love the performance of this shoe. This has been my go-to shoe since we did the play test on it. But it fits my foot like a glove, and it's got good stability, plenty of underfoot cushioning. So can't say enough good things about the Gel Res 7. I know you like it a lot too, Chris. And then my second item is the new Vocal V-Fill 10 320. So they lightened it up by 5 grams compared to the V-Sense 10 325, but it has about the same swing weight. So I didn't really notice the difference in weight too much, but the one thing I am noticing is it's got a little stiffer layup of graphite. So it's got like a 66 RA, kind of like the V-Sense 10 Tour. So it's a little bit firmer, but still super comfortable from the handle system that Vocal has. So great control, really liking this racket. And there's just enough room for weight where I can add a leather and a little bit of weight in the hoop.
And I know you like to do that. Yeah. Next up, a playtester I always look up to, Michelle. Come on in, Michelle. Tell us what you're rocking out there on the court.
First up, I've got the Bisner, as we're calling it around the office, the new Prince Beast Pro 100 LB. So it's the John Isner endorsed racket, a little extended in length, and it has a 351 swing weight. So I'm still enjoying this after the playtest, really trying to get dialed in with my timing. It is a little beefy, but it's been really fun to just push my opponents around and crack balls with. So keep this in the bag for sure. And then next is my new favorite string from Prince, this Diablo Prism. Oh my gosh, I'm feeling so nostalgic. It reminds me of when I was a little kid and I had the rainbow strings in my little racket. And it's a polyester, so it's been awesome. I know we've been putting it in almost every racket just because it's really fun, but it's also a good performing string. For what I like to string at, it's giving me nice control, consistent feel. So I'm continuing to enjoy the fun, colorful pop in my rackets.
Awesome, thanks, Michelle. Let's check in with Sean next. Sean, come in. Tell us what you've been rocking out on the court.
Yeah, thanks, Chris. First thing I've got for you guys is the Yonex V-Core 95. Now, the SV line I felt was a little too stiff for me, but the RA number is coming in a little lower on these, so it's a little more buttery and smooth and low-powered, and that's right in my wheelhouse for my game. I like it with the Slinko Hyper G. I think it plays great. It gives it a little more spin potential. So I'm loving this, really considering using it in this tournament coming up. The second thing I have for you is the Hydro Flask Growler. It's really important to stay hydrated there out on court, and I found that this is all the water I need for 2 or 3 sets, and I've even taken it camping a few times. It's great. It's durable, and I put a little sticker on there. I love it. So Hydro Flask makes a great product, and no matter what size you get, they're just doing a solid job. Thanks.
Yep. Thanks. I love those Hydro Flasks, too. They keep the liquid cool or hot. All day long. They really are awesome products. Next up, I'm going to go through my gear, and like Sean, I went with one of the V-Cores, and I've chosen the 98, and I hit the 100, the 95, and the 98, and I really felt like this one was the one that was sweet as a nut, as I like to say. It was just right in the middle there, offered great performance. I thought it had a blend of the softness of the 95, but a bit more Christmas with the 100, and so I thought it was a really great modern player's racket. Ton of spin out of this one. Really liked it from the ground strokes all the way through to the volleys. Just could really manipulate what I wanted to do with the ball really well with that racket. Fun one. Definitely get that on your demo list if you're a fan of player's rackets in the 98 square inch head size. And then my last product here is the Nike Zoom Zero. I remember seeing this on some players' feet when we were back in Indian Wells earlier this year, and I saw it on Tiafo and Jack Sock were rocking these out on the practice court, and I was super jelly watching them running around in it. I was dying to get out on the court in it, and as soon as we started play testing it, I love this shoe. It's really fast. It gets you up on the toes thanks to that curved midsole outsole design. It grips the court really well, but there's enough give so you can slide out of shots too. It's got a half booty construction, which really locks my feet in. I know some players have had issues getting their foot in the shoe, so if you have a high instep, just expect a little bit of a struggle once you get it in, but once it breaks in, that's going to open up a little bit for you. But once you got your foot in this shoe, it really does hold your foot really well, does everything you need. Support, stability, cushioning, and comfort all in a great performing shoe. And I think it looks super sick as well. Love that one right there. Okay, that's all we got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.